budget airline Ryanair has made a joke with Meghan Markle after her £1 payout over her lawsuit with the Mail on Sunday, with the company telling her to wait for their sale to spend her winnings. Meghan Markle's recent £1 payout over a privacy lawsuit with the Mail on Sunday has prompted Ryanair to joke about the situation on Twitter. The budget airline used the opportunity to advise the Duchess of Sussex to save her compensation to book a holiday with them once they have their next sale. The cheeky tweet from Ryanair towards the Duchess said, "Save that for our next seat sale, Meg hashtag Meghan Markle hashtag Ryanair." Their tweet prompted laughter from those following the account, with some suggesting their social media team deserves a raise and some calling it tweet of the day. One user said, "This had me cracking up all day." While another commented, "They only fly private." As well as those commenting on Ryanair's tweet, some fans of Meghan tweeted in support of the Duchess over the fee she received. One tweeted, "She has always maintained she took on this case because of principle, not money." Meghan Markle received the princely sum of £1, $1.35, in damages from the publishers of the Daily Mail and the Mail Online in a settlement for her privacy action against them, after they published a handwritten letter she sent to her estranged father. The retired star libel lawyer David Hooper told that it would be a mistake to read the paltry amount of the award against Meghan as indicative of any weakness in her case, which she won definitively. He said the much more important fact was that Associated Newspapers Limited, ANL, had agreed to cover a substantial portion of Meghan's legal costs, meaning she had not only proved her point of principle, something Meghan has always said was far more important to her than the money, but also inflicted significant financial damage on the publishers. He said it was likely that if Meghan had wanted to secure a larger amount of money, she would have been involved in further legal wrangling, with ANL possibly demanding she prove what damage she had suffered. By accepting a token amount, the matter was now closed without further negotiations. The publisher has also agreed to pay a confidential sum in damages for copyright infringement. Her spokesperson described this payment as substantial and said it will be donated to charity. Accepting the £1 will likely have avoided a tremendous argument about the extent of the damage she suffered. She just wanted to establish a principle and get her legal costs paid, although she may well still be £500,000 out of pocket as a result of this process. They would say it was about the principle of the thing, but if they hope that because of this the Mail will not write about them anymore, they are in cloud cuckoo land. They've inflicted a financial loss on the Mail, but it is a company with deep pockets. Obviously the Mail would have preferred to win, but Meghan did nothing for her reputation by her memory lapse over some of the evidence. In a statement after her court victory, Meghan Markle criticized the harmful practices of tabloids as a daily fail that divide us. "This is a victory not just for me, but for anyone who has ever felt scared to stand up for what's right," she said. The Duchess called on people to be collectively brave enough to reshape a tabloid industry that conditions people to be cruel, and profits from the lies and pain that they create. She accused ANL of dragging the trial out and attempting to twist facts and manipulate the public, even during the appeal itself, making a straightforward case extraordinarily convoluted in order to generate more headlines and sell more newspapers, a model that rewards chaos above truth.